Madison Reidy's been following this story for months. And Maddie, why are they doing this?
Mike, the aim of this is to stop home buyers from drowning in debt.
About half of those mortgages are considered risky.
So the daddy of the economy is pumping the brakes.
The country's biggest bank, ANZ, says that it's reviewing its affordability equations when it comes to property investors. What responsibility does ANZ take for making housing unaffordable?
You know, we're not going to turn someone away who wants to own their own home.
Maddie, what do the banks involved have to say about this?
Mike, ASB has refused to comment today, but ANZ told me that they will defend this claim.
And Madison, there's some breaking news tonight about one of our other big banks.
In a shocking announcement, Westpac Australia has said that it's considering the sale of its entire New Zealand business.
I think it was definitely a catch-up budget for sure, and we heard Grant Robertson say that he was writing that wrong of, you know, 1991.
He's thrown almost all responsibility to rein in house price growth across the road from the Beehive to his mates at the Reserve Bank, and this budget is a huge risk to inflation.
Newshub business reporter Madison Reidy joins us now with more Madison.
Well, Sam, it can come as no surprise. The R word is here. This is now wildly out of date.
Okay, Madison, the question many are worried about, when might mortgage rates rise again?
Sam, that is a matter of when, not if.
How much money collectively is being dangled in front of your face?
Oh, I mean, I've certainly got approaches from people that have the potential to invest billions.
Yes, trillion. We are going to be posting huge deficits of, you know, 15 billion this year, 18 billion next year. If you look at the core crown net debt going forward, it is huge. It peaks at $184 billion.
Maddie, should we expect this boom to continue?
Well, Mike, people here are certainly showing no signs of slowing down on the bears just yet. I think they're celebrating GDP figures, but I'm not entirely sure.
There's never been a better time to ask for a raise. So, boss, I know you're watching. I look forward to your call.
Good luck with that, Maddie.
Yes.
Well, Eric, there's not many places we can travel to these days, but tomorrow for Super Saturday, Aucklanders can go to Destination Vaccination. My cheeks hurt just from smiling so much, and I think everyone here has definitely cried more than once today.
Things are looking up for the airline.
Mel, it certainly is. Air New Zealand is giving all of its staff $1,000 in shares or cash, and those who've been on reduced salaries will be back on full pay again from next year. That's because capacity on its domestic network is now back to 90% of what it was before COVID.
It'll take the small wins on the way. Fist pumping when required. Madison Reidy, Newshub.